गाइस, माई सेल्फ महेश भीकुट एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ द बायो मॉलिक्यूल दैट इज नथिंग बट डी एंड एल कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑफ द ग्लूकोज एंड फ्रुक्टोज एंड एज वेल एज द ओपन साइक्लिक एंड हावर स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑफ ग्लूकोज एंड फ्रुक्टोज. ओके, सो स्टार्टिंग विद डी एंड एल कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑफ ग्लूकोज. सो वॉट आर डी एंड एल? D and L configuration of anything, glucose, glyceraldehyde or fructose, anything. Look at here guys, D means what? So you all know what is the structure of the glucose. 6 carbon atoms, 1 2 3 4 5 and 6, 6 carbon atoms having CH2OH group, is it? And here OH OH H OH, and here it is, yes it is an carbonyl group. Which group? Carbonyl means aldehyde group. If it is OH here, we have to add H here. H is there, you have to add OH. OH is there, H. OH is there, H. So this is what glucose structure. I hope you understood guys. So this is what structure of the glucose. If this one is your carbonyl group, how it is located? Like this. Aldehyde group is located like this. This one is carbonyl group. So when we count from the carbonyl group, the last carbon of this molecule, which one is that? Last carbon, last but first. So this carbon, if this carbon having OH group right side, if this carbon having OH group right side, that is called D-glucose. What is that? D-glucose. So starting from the carbonyl carbon, last but first carbon having OH group, this group, right side, therefore this one is called D-glucose. Similarly, that OH is there, you have to add H here, that's it. H is there, you have to add OH, similarly. So look at here. So what is the difference between these two structures? This is also glucose, this is also glucose. Look at here, this carbon atom, remaining all are same. H is there, OH, 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 OH. Only this position, here OH is there in the right side. Here OH is there on the left side. Therefore this is called L-glucose. What this one is called? L-glucose. So D-glucose means OH on the right side. L-glucose means OH group on the left side. So this is what DL configurations of glucose. I hope you understood guys. Starting from the carbonyl carbon, last but first carbon, last one is this carbon, that first carbon is there, no, last but first. So that carbon having OH group right side, that is called D-glucose. If that carbon is having OH group left side, that is called L-glucose. Is it? So this is what D and L configuration of glucose. So these two structures are also called open structures of glucose. What they are called? Open structures of glucose. So these two structures are called open structures of glucose. Okay, next we are going to discuss what are the open structure and cyclic structure and how are structures of the glucose. Okay, let's move on. So open structure, as you know, as previous, like this only. OH OH H OH. Okay. So this is no OH is right side. So therefore this one is D glucose. And also it is also called alpha D glucose. What is that? Alpha D glucose. And another one is there, that is beta D glucose or beta L glucose or beta D glucose, whatever. So OH right side is there D, OH left side is there, then it is an
एल एच इज देयर देन एड ओ एच इफ ओ एच इज देयर देन एड एच सो दिस वन इज डी दिस वन इज एल इज इट सो दिस इज अ ओपन स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ग्लूकोज विच स्ट्रक्चर गाइस ओपन फर्स्ट वन इज ओपन स्ट्रक्चर सेकेंड वन वी विल स्टडी रिगार्डिंग दी दिस वन इज ओपन स्ट्रक्चर नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी रिगार्डिंग दी साइक्लिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ग्लूकोज साइक्लिक स्ट्रक्चर सो वॉट आर द साइक्लिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ग्लूकोज इज मीन्स नथिंग बट So here only I will show you how the cyclic structure is locating. So this is open structure is there now. So in this here first one carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, fifth carbon. This is first carbon. So lone pair on the oxygen will attack carbonyl carbon. As a result, this will go here and that H is taken by here. So what we are obtaining is look at here. This double bond becomes single bond OH. It will start as a OH and that as it is. Look at here. OH may be this side. Is it OH may be this side? Second carbon, third carbon, fourth, fifth. This one is sixth. Okay. Here it is a bond making. Look at here. This one is your oxygen. OH is there as it is. So one H is there. You write here. So remaining all as it is. So here it is OH is there, and here H is there. Again OH. H is there, add OH. OH is there, add H. So look at this one is a cyclic structure of glucose. That we have derived that cyclic structure from the alpha D glucose. Therefore this is called alpha cyclic structure of glucose. Alpha pyranose we can call. Is it? So look at here. OH is on the left side. Look at here. OH is on the left side. So therefore, this one is called beta. This one is called beta glucose. If OH is on the this side, so then we can call it as a. We can write like this. Carefully see here. Yeah, bonding. Or else we can also form like this. C OH. You write H here. Now OH this side. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Fifth carbon is attached like this, and here oxygen is there. Is it? So remaining all are same. OH, H, OH. So carefully see these two structure, guys. Here OH is first carbon. OH is at left side. Here first carbon OH is at right side. So therefore this one is called beta glucose. And this one is called alpha glucose. This one is called alpha glucose. So when this alpha D glucose is just attacking takes place from this oxygen to this carbonyl group, this eliminates as it is. Look at here. These electron goes to the oxygen, and these electron present on the oxygen will attack on the carbonyl group. As a result, this will minus charge. That minus and here H is there now. That H plus added as a OH and remaining O as is. Look at it. This O is nothing but this O. Okay. So we can get two products, right? One is OH may be below side, this left side. OH may be right side. So if OH left side is there, that is beta D glucose. OH right side is there. This OH is right side is there, then that is alpha glucose. I hope you understood, guys. This is regarding cyclic structure of glucose. So this is an open structure. These are the cyclic structure of glucose. Now another structure is remaining, that is Haworth structure. How Haworth structure is located, we will study that one. I hope you understood. Third one, Haworth structure of glucose. So you know cyclic structure. this is alpha D glucose, right? Alpha D glucose or alpha glucose, whatever you call. So this one is an alpha glucose. So what is HAWA structure means? They will take this cyclic structure only and take it in a six-membered ring like this. Is it? This oxygen is nothing but this oxygen. So as the oxygen is connected to this carbon, so this carbon you treat as a, if OH is right side, if OH is right side, we have to write in below, in HAWA structure, in HAWA structure. If OH is right side on the closed cyclic structure of the glucose, we write in the below in HAWA structure. Look at here. This oxygen is there, this oxygen connected to this carbon. OH is right side. You write below here OH. And this side H is there, you add H here. Okay. OH is below, write below here OH. This side H. H is right side. So you write right side H. So left side OH is there. Look at here. Left side OH. You write left side OH. Next, OH is below again. OH is below, H is here. Then this carbon atom having CH2OH, no? That you have to show like this. CH2OH and H. Carefully look here. In HAWA structure, whatever there on the right side, we have to take that all things on the below side. That's it. Look at here. Oxygen is there, oxygen. That oxygen is attached to carbon. Is it this carbon? So that carbon having OH right side, therefore the OH is below. H left side, therefore the H is above. Look at here. Again, second carbon OH is right side. So taken OH right side. H is left side, therefore H is above. So whatever there on the right side, you take below. Whatever there on the left side, take above. And remaining CH2OH is there, no? That also you have to take in the above plane. This is what HAWA structure of glucose. So OH is on the below, that is nothing but on the right side, therefore this is called alpha glucose. What this is called? Alpha glucose. Similarly beta, beta means everything is same, only OH is above. Because this OH is on the left side in the beta glucose. Is it? You take OH above, H below, that's it. Look at here, same copy. Is it? OH is below, you take above, that's it, this curve. So remaining all are same. As it is, OH is there, H is there, then H is there, OH is there, here, OH is there, H is there, here as it is, CH2OH and here H. Look at here, OH below, nothing but right side on the cyclic structure, therefore this is called alpha, this is also called alpha. Here, OH is above. In HAWA structure, OH is above means in the cyclic structure, OH is left side. If left side means it is, yes, it is beta glucose. So this is what HAWA structure of glucose. So up to this, we have studied guys regarding first one, open structure of glucose, nothing but Fischer formula. What we have did in the structural elucidation second part, like that only. Second one, cyclic structure of glucose, nothing but this one. Then third one, HAWA structure of glucose, nothing but this one. So what is the difference between cyclic and HAWA means? Same as it is, structure is will be there. But thing is that whatever the functional group, whatever the elements present on the right side on the cyclic structure, they will come here below. That's it. But whatever there on the left side, they will come above the plane. And the CH2OH also comes on the above. So here H is there, that H will be below. Left side is there, that's it. Right side below, left side above, and one this CH2OH also above, this one. And OH is below, that means OH is right side, that is called alpha. Here OH is below, that is called alpha. If OH is left side, then that is called beta. Here OH is above, that is called beta. OH below, alpha. OH above, beta. So this one regarding three different structures of the glucose. I hope you understood guys. Now we will switch on to the next one, that is open structure of fructose, cyclic structure of fructose and HAWA structure of fructose. Okay, next we will switch on to the fructose. Look at here. First we will study this structure of the fructose, open structure. So here also 6 carbon. What is the formula of fructose? C6H12O6. As similar that of the glucose. Same molecular formula is there, but structural formula is different. Look at here. Here also 6 carbons are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. CH2OH is there as it is. But here in case of glucose, there is a carbonyl group, aldehyde group. But here it is an, here also it is CH2OH only. And here in glucose, there is an OH. But here it is double bond O. Here the ketone group is shifted here. Remaining all are same. OH, OH, H. So if H is there, this side, OH you have to add. If OH is there, this side we have to add H. OH is there, we have to add H. So this is what? Open structure of fructose. So look at here. Last, this is carbonyl group. Last but first. So carbon containing OH group, right side. So therefore this one is, yes, this one is, here OH is right side, alpha. Here OH is also right side. Therefore it is D, alpha D. It is not a glucose. Now it is, in this case, it is a fructose. So what is the difference between glucose and fructose, guys? Here carbonyl group is there. In glucose, first only carbonyl group is there. Here functional group is ketone. There the functional group is aldehyde. And in here, above and below, two last carbon also and first carbon also, you are getting CH2OH, CH2OH. Nothing but primary OH groups. I hope you understood, guys. So this one is alpha. So if you wanted to write a beta, means you write, just exchange this one. That's it. Look at here. CH2OH as it is. This double bond O as it is. Third one, H as it is. This OH as it is. Now, last OH, whatever you are writing now, that you have to write left side. That's it. Is it? Remaining all as it is. CH2OH. So, OH is there, add H. H is there, add OH. Double bond O is there, add as it is. Look at here. Only this carbon. Carefully see this carbon atom. OH is right side. Forming. This CH2OH as it is, you write CH2OH this side. CH2OH, here carbon, here OH, is it? So here one bond is there, that you have to write, show in like this. Okay, remaining, C is there, C, H, here OH, next C, here also H, look at here also H, remaining C, OH and H. So lastly you are having CH2OH as it is, you write. But this carbon, look at this one, this is just attacked on this carbon and forming O. Look at here. This O is attacked here and O is taken this H. So OH, this becomes OH and this O remains as it is. So here, this is what? Cyclic structure of fructose. This one is fructose. Nothing but OH is right side. So alpha, OH, D. Here OH is also right side. So alpha D fructose. Name of this one is alpha D fructose. But here it is cyclic structure. Here also this is an alpha. Thing is that, look at here. OH is right side. Therefore here also it is alpha D. Fructose only. So this OH, look at here. This O may attack carbonyl carbon on the front side. Or this may attack on the back side. That means this OH may be this side. Or OH may be left side. So if OH is, this OH group is right side. So therefore it is an alpha D fructose. Another you can write. Look at here. These 6 carbon atoms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Same thing. Look at here, OH is this side, that is alpha. If you write OH this side, then CH2OH this side. Remaining same. H is there, OH is there. Look at it, one extra carbon I have written, sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 carbon I have written. Sorry for that, just remove one carbon atom here. Look at, OH is there. So, H you add, OH you add. So, here, look at here. OH group is right side, that is alpha D glucose. If OH group is left side, that is beta D glucose. Sorry, glucose not, it is a fructose. Beta D fructose. So, as that of the open chain structure, in cyclic structure, this carbonyl carbon, so this one is carbonyl carbon, so starting from this one, last but first carbon O group is going to attack on the carbonyl carbon. As early as go to attack on the carbonyl carbon, this electron shifted to oxygen. If this electron shifted to oxygen, oxygen bearing negative charge, that negative charge is taken by this H and OH is formed. Nothing but this OH may be right side, that OH may be left side. If that OH is right side, that is called beta alpha. If OH is left side, that is called beta. And this CH2OH, you can show here also and here also. Look at here. This one is CH2OH, this one is your CH2OH. So this is open chain structure of fructose and cyclic structure of fructose. Alpha D fructose, beta D fructose. Why this one is called alpha? Because OH is on the right side, therefore alpha. Why it is D? Look at this. This hydrogen OH also and this OH also on the right side, therefore it is D. Here also same. Here OH, OH right side, therefore D. But here first OH is left side, therefore it is beta. I hope you understood, guys. This one, open chain structure and cyclic structure of fructose. Now last one, that is Howard structure of glucose. Look at here, third one, Howard structure of glucose. Howard structure of fructose, sorry, not glucose, sorry. It is an fructose. Howard structure of fructose. Nothing but, you know, how many members are there in the cyclic ring? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Look at here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Look at here also, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 members ring we have to make. Look at here. This one. Is it a 5 member ring? Okay. This one is an O. Now, oxygen containing carbon is attached to OH. So, whatever present on the right side of the right side, so those are taken in the below in Howard structure. Look at here. OH is right side is there. So, you have to take below OH. So, this side CH2OH as it is. Next. Carbon, next carbon having H right side. So, H you have to take a below. OH, right side. Whatever the elements present on the right side, we have to take below in the Howard structure. So, remaining next carbon, OH, H. So, OH right side is there, you have to write below this one. Last one, look at here. This one. CH2OH is there, that you have to take above. CH2OH also above, remaining H is below. This is, look at here. OH group below, nothing but OH group right side, nothing but alpha D fructose. Here also same. OH group below. OH group below means here OH group right side. Nothing but alpha D fructose. This one is alpha D fructose. So if you wanted to see beta D fructose, nothing but. So shall I rub this? I'll write. This Howard structure, this one alpha D. If you wanted to write beta, nothing but that is also same. 5 member transition state you have to take. Cyclic transition state. Okay, look at here. This oxygen containing carbon is this one. In that side, CH2OH is left right side. That means you have to take below CH2OH here. Here above OH. Only this much for, this much difference. If you turn this one, OH above CH2OH below, that's it. Remaining entire thing is same. Look at remaining entire thing is same. Look at here. So what is difference between that? Here OH is below, therefore it is an alpha. Here OH is above, therefore it is an beta D fructose. Beta D fructose. I hope you understood, guys. This is regarding Howard structure of fructose. So up to this, what we have studied? So first one we have studied the open structure of glucose, cyclic structure of glucose, and then Howard structure of glucose. After that, open structure of fructose, cyclic structure of fructose, and Howard structure of fructose. So in open structure of glucose, what we did? So nothing but as that of the we have studied in the structural elucidation of glucose, no? Like that, same formula, Fischer projection, what we can call. After that, cyclic structure of glucose, what we did? Starting from the carbonyl carbon, last but first carbon oxygen will attack on the carbonyl group. So as a result, if OH is right side, that is alpha. If OH is left side, that is beta. Similarly, in case of Howard structure of glucose, what we did? So we've taken 6-member cyclic ring there. 6-member cyclic ring. So if in 6-member cyclic ring, whatever there in Fischer projection, that is open structure, whatever the elements there on the right side, we have taken on the below of that ring, this one, below of that ring, and whatever on the left side, we taken above of the ring. Understood. Similarly, in case of fructose, fructose also same thing. So whatever there in the open structure on the right side, we have taken in the below in this Howard structure, and whatever on the left side, they are taken above in the Howard structure. Okay, we will just recall that one and conclude this video here only. So we have studied. Yes. We have studied Howard structures, mainly important Howarth and cyclic structure. We will just write Howarth structure only here. So this one is glucose. Okay, Howarth structure only we will write. Howarth structure, that to alpha here. So here also Howarth structure. You write beta here. Okay, so what is the open chain structure of glucose? This one, CHO 3 4 5 1 2 3 4 5. So this one is in sixth carbon atom, is it? So what we will take, this oxygen will attack here. So what we are getting then, this is nothing but COH. So this oxygen is attacking, means this is OH, this side maybe, or that side maybe. Look at it. One, two, three, four, five. This one is six. CH2H. OH. OH. H. OH. So this one is CHO. So if OH is there, this side you have to add H. H is there, this side you have to add OH. That's it. This is open chain structure of glucose. So here you have to write fructose. Here also six carbon atoms. One, two, three, four, five, six. Here CH2OH. Here OH, OH, H and double bond O, and here also CH2OH. So here H is there, you have to add OH, OH is there, you have to add H, OH is there, you have to add. So this is open structure of glucose and fructose. What are the Howarth structure of glucose? Look at here, six member transition ring we have to form here. Is it six member transition state? So here in this case, what we have to do? We have to attack this carbonyl carbon to this. Is it? Yes, this oxygen to on this carbonyl carbon. Nothing but we are getting this structure. Look at here. This one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. This side. OH is right side is there. So we have tried to get it. Oxygen containing carbon. Oxygen containing carbon having OH right side. So we have to write here below OH. This side H is there. Next carbon, OH below, you write below here only. Then below H is there, means right side H is there, you have to write below H. So this side OH. So remaining, again, yes, OH right side means it will take an above. And remaining CH2OH we should write in the top way. CH2OH and H. So this is alpha. So what we have to do for beta, just reverse this. OH may be above, H is below, that's it. Here also six member transition state is there, six member cyclic ring. So just you have to take OH here, H here, only this much difference, remaining all is same. Look at here, OH is there, H, H, OH, OH, H, CH2OH, and here CHOH, and here H. So this is beta. This is alpha. OH below means in the right side. So same way in case of fructose. Look at here. Fructose, this carbonyl carbon, oxygen, will attack on this carbonyl carbon. Nothing but what we are getting is, look at here. This CH2OH becomes this side. OH becomes this side and attack here. Okay. Here oxygen will come. So, look at here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 member ring we have to make. See, this is a 5 member ring. Oxygen containing carbon having OH right side. So, oxygen containing carbon having OH right side means below we have to write OH. That side, CH2OH is there. You write CH2OH as it is. This one is your CH2OH. Next, H is right side. So, you write below H. H is right side means below H. this side OH. Here H is right side, you take OH here. OH is right side, take OH below. So here it is an H. Next one, look at here, CH2OH is there, so CH2OH you taken as an above side, and remaining here H is there, that you take below. So look at here, OH is below, right side, nothing but alpha fructose. This one is regarding fructose. Then here also 5 member cyclic ring, but thing is that OH is above here in this side, only this carbon, that's it, this OH is above. Okay, remaining everything is same, H, OH, OH, H, here H, and CH2OH. I hope you understood, guys. Just this one is on beta, because OH above means it is left side, that's it. So this one is alpha fructose, this one is beta fructose, alpha glucose, beta glucose. So these are the Hauer structures of fructose and glucose. I hope you understood, guys. If you have any doubts, queries, you please comment below. Thank you for watching. Stay home, stay safe.